just what one or two notices to announce, domestic matters. First of all, for our own people, the Christmas cards for distribution are on the table downstairs in the Waverley Room. If you would be good enough to pick up those in your area, we'd be grateful. Then fire escapes. There's one up there, there's another here, there's one at the back, the old entrance doors, or down there. So that deals with that. Orchard House, on Tuesday at 2 p.m, there is a carol service at Orchard House, and normally a number go along to support it. So you're asked to do that if you wish. They provide quite a spread, mince pies and drinks afterwards, and the people there love to meet us. So that's 2 o'clock on Tuesday. After the service here, downstairs in the Wesley Room, there will be coffee and mince pies. And now it's my pleasure to thank Mr. Nick Farnell, the organ, and our own minister, the Reverend Steve Jacob. Thank you, Steve.
Well, good evening, everybody. It's lovely to see so many of you here. Just a quick note about Orchard House. It's not so much a service, it's panels and readings, and it's at 2 o'clock on Tuesday, and everybody's invited to come along. I'm not remembering it, really, so if you're doing nothing Tuesday afternoon, please pop in. So I'll say it's lovely to see you. Arthur's done most of the welcoming, so all I'll say is the service will run continually. They are quite traditional with the carols and the readings, just going one after the other. And towards the end, we'll have the traditional candle lighting, hence telling you where all the fire exits were. And so we'll just have a lovely festive kickoff for this year's Christmases. So welcome all to the Hours we are singing now. Once in Royal Navy.
Oh.
walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. A shoot shall come out from the stock of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the kid. The calf and the lion and the fatling together. And a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze. Their young shall lie down together. And the lion shall eat straw like an ox. The nursing child shall play with the hole of the asp. And the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea.
Thank you. town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favoured one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favour with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Oh,
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. And they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find the child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those whom he favours." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger.
Oh, the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born king of the Jews? For we observe his star, it is rising, and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea. For so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means the least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler, which shall shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called the wise men and learned from them the exact time the star appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out. And there ahead of them went the star that they had seen its rising, and it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that star stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was light, and the light was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God. Who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh, and lived amongst us. And we have seen his glory, the glory of the Father's only Son, full of grace.
Take my life on my own hands. This church has very kindly invited me back for another 5 years. I probably wish they hadn't after this. Anyway, let's get a measure of it. How does God keep Wences that's like his pizza? Deep pan, crisp, and even. Okay, here goes. I'm going to try and retell that story. Something amazing has happened. The world has changed. It has a whole new flavour. The one who made everybody now has a body. The one true God, the real McCoy, was born as a child to show us the way to live and the way to God. Let me tell you how it happened. One day in a quiet village in Israel to a young woman called Mary, an angel appeared from nowhere. Mary quavered. Don't be afraid, said the angel. You've been chosen. You'll be the mother of God's own son. He'll be a sensation. He will save people. Some people will think he's nuts. But he will be God's promised king. The one everyone has been waiting for. So we fast forward 9 months. There's a new tax set by the government which has hit the poor the hardest. That sounds familiar, doesn't it? But anyway, everyone has to walk a long way to the place of birth to register and pay. From Nazareth, where Mary and Joseph lived, to Bethlehem was a journey of about 80 miles on foot, pregnant. They were pretty frazzled when they got to Joseph's town of Bethlehem. Gets worse. Listen very carefully. They knocked at the first door, it opened into a full house. No room here. And again they found the same problem. Now the Bible says Jesus was born in a manger, a feeding trough for animals. Often people kept their animals in a section of their house overnight. And maybe the innkeeper, with all the guest room full, invited Mary and Joseph into his house to stay as his personal guests. Now you know how a crisp packet can feel full, but in fact there's lots of space. Well, it's like that with us. Our lives are full of stuff. But like the innkeeper, there's always room for Jesus. So let's add a little bit more flavour to the story. There were shepherds on a hill outside Bethlehem. They were the salt of the earth. watching over their lands, chilly in the night air, maybe baking something over a warm fire. They're night security men. They haven't got much stake in the world. But they soon turned chicken as a light appeared in the sky. What's it doing? It's getting closer. What's it doing? It's getting closer. It's getting brighter. It's angels. Don't be afraid, said the angels, as the shepherds quavered. Good news. Your Saviour is born down there in Bethlehem, Jesus the King. And so they skipped off to see the child and worship and spread the good news. Meanwhile, far in the east, men who studied the stars saw a strange sky, sign in the sky. Saturn, the planet of Israel, close to Jupiter, the planet of kings. So close they looked like a single star, a new king in Israel. There were great stories. There were great prophecies. So they packed up their gifts, not knick-knacks, but great treasures, and set out across the deep, rich desert. Many weeks later, dry and roasted by the sun, they reached the royal palace in Jerusalem. This is where you'd find King Herod. Not the right king. The palace of Herod, the man who had his family killed when they looked like being more popular than he was. Herod was a monster. Munching a new king, and he'd not be happy. Herod hoped the wise men would not twig. Let me know where he is, so that I can worship him too. But they weren't called wise men for nothing, and they kept Jesus a secret. Just a few miles further, and the star showed them where Jesus was. They gave him gifts of frankincense, myrrh, and gold in wonder at this child, the promised king, the Son of God. Now, what are crisps made from? Potatoes. You put one small potato in the ground, and it grows and makes lots more. And so from that small beginning, now the Christmas story is told all over the world, and millions of people know Jesus, and they follow him, and they love him. All sorts of shapes and sizes and flavors. God's gift to the world. And we discovered that Jesus is worth all we can give. The love of Mary, the faithfulness of Joseph, the excitement of the shepherds, the song of the angels, the precious gifts of the wise men. And the truth is crisp. Christ really is someone precious. So this Christmas, taste and see for yourself.
For Ruth, Steve, and for Mark, and for all who serve in various other positions. We pray that we may all benefit from the various gifts that we have to offer in the service of Christ, that in faith and unity we may be constantly renewed by your Holy Spirit for mission. Lord, in your mercy. Dear Lord, we pray today for peace in our world and an end to violence. May there be peace in our homes and hearts, so that we may live and work together in a spirit of peace and harmony. Remind us all that we share your world with others, all made in your image, regardless of race, creed or colour. Purify the minds and attitudes of men and women in leadership, especially in this country as we move closer to the general election, so that they present a better, more honest attitude and stop the constant bickering and backbiting which has become such a part of modern politics. Help them to bring about a peaceful, united country rather than the violent images portrayed by the words that they use, which only help to agitate those troubled in spirit. May the world know the peace of Christ, without which society loses its direction and ignores our deep desire for peace. Lord, in your mercy, give grace to us, our families and friends, and to all our neighbours, that we may serve Christ in one another and love as he loves us. Help us to make our homes places which reflect the pattern of your love, places of mutual trust and forgiveness, places of true sharing and caring, places of deep joy and peace, and unite us all, one to another, in the circle of your love. In this season of Advent, we celebrate the first coming of your Son to us in Bethlehem. May we joyfully anticipate the day when Christ will come again. May our Advent season be a preparation for the day when we are taken to the joy of heaven, where waiting will be no more, and all our hopes will be fulfilled. Lord, in your mercy, Lord, in your mercy. merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Singing Silent Night as we light the candles, I would suggest we stay seated, and then at the end of this song the lights will just go down for a short while in silence, and then I'll ask you to blow the candles out and sing Silent Night, Holy Night, always come. Sing, hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
Thank you.
you all so much for joining us this evening. You're all invited to come downstairs for a mince pie and a cup of coffee. I'm sure we've got enough to go around. And may I wish you all a very happy Christmas tide. And may God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon you all now this Christmas and remain.